Coming up on KCTV, you've heard it once, you've heard it a thousand times. No backpacks in class, and we want to know why.
And do you know what's popping? It's more than just popcorn. We'll explain because KCTV starts right now. I want to fly like an eagle to the sea.
Why'd you get the small one?
Red Ribbon Week concludes. Thanks to all of you who've taken the pledge to be drug-free. I'm Leah Bowles.
And I'm Stan. Welcome to KCTV. We'd also like to thank those teachers who have shown that they'd rather eat bugs than take drugs. About a dozen teachers took time to eat some chocolate-covered pests.
Look at it.
It has an eye.
It has a family.
Swish it around.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Swish it around. Yeah.
What is it, an earthworm?
Oh.
How tasty. Closer to the classroom, teachers have been asked to make sure they follow the backpack policy a little more closely. But that's just creating a few headaches for some students.
Oliver Lang has more.
Recently, Centennial High administration has been buckling down on backpacks. This policy, created years ago, was put into place for clutter and safety reasons. But students seem to be having trouble with this rule. We meet with Mr. Hainer to explain the consequences of bringing a backpack to class.
I think probably the person would just be asked to take it to their locker and maybe get a tardy because they weren't ready for class. And then it might go up from there.
As a student athlete, I really just want to bring my books and binders to class. I have to be to practice right after school. If I had my backpack, I wouldn't be late to practice as much.
We head on over to REI to take a deeper look at the backpacking industry.
One of the ones that I really like is right here is the Osprey Manta and the Mira. The Mira is the women's version. A good way to organize your day, to have everything you need for the day and just build organizational skills. I understand where they're coming from, but I think the backpack should be allowed.
Although it may seem like an inconvenience to some students, it's still a rule. Centennial High, Ollie Lang, KCTV.
It's hard to believe that the first quarter of the school year is now over. Seniors, if you haven't started thinking about next year, it's time to start. Here's Townsley's Tip of the Week.
Morning, Patriots. Mrs. Townsley here with a tip for the seniors. I want to talk to you guys about the FAFSA, the Free Application for Federal Student Aid. You really need to fill that out, and if you haven't done it yet, there's still time. So I have a sign up here in the Career Center. You can see we have a lot of people signed up. There's no shame in signing up to get help on your FAFSA. If you'd like to get some help, then just come in here and pick a time spot, and then I'll give you this handout that tells you exactly what you need to bring to FAFSA night. The reason why it's important to fill out your FAFSA is, first of all, it's a Pell Grant, free money from the government if you qualify. If you don't qualify for the free money, you might qualify for work study or lower interest loans. And if you don't qualify for any of that, you might get private scholarships based on your FAFSA. Now, there's a scholarship called the Opportunity Scholarship that if you are an Idaho student going to an Idaho school, the Idaho Opportunity Scholarship is one you need to apply for, and you have to fill out the FAFSA in order to get that one. It's not based on financial need. It's based on a mixture of academic and financial need.
Halloween is this Monday. Beginning tomorrow, you can lock on to our YouTube channel and watch a few scary movies, courtesy of our Video 2 students. Just search for KCTV Centennial Halloween 2016. Here's a trailer previewing one of those movies.
Ryan, get the lights.
Do you have any idea what you have done to me? Watch out. I'm coming for you.
And that's KCTV for today. I'm Stan.
And I'm Leah. Have a great weekend. I can turn a gray sky blue.